Hello to you all. We here on this earth is this small global village, and all of us are thinking, why are we here for? What is my purpose? What is my tikkun? What is my reparation, fixation in this world? What am I doing here? Well, one of the major things we are here for is to work at our attributes. What does it mean to work at our attributes? It means that we've got different kind of attributes which cause us to be either very close to the animalistic world, anger, vengeance, begrudging other people, egoistical issues that we have, for example, or being jealous of others, or that we can work at ourselves and empower ourselves and elevate ourselves above these levels. What do I mean? For example, three things we are told by our sages can take a person completely out of this world, which is jealousy, seeking honor, ego, and lusts and desires, are basic drives. Well, what should I do about them? Should I try to suppress them? Should I try to break them? Should I try to nullify them? It cannot be nullified because it's ingrained in our nature. So what does God want from us? What he requires from us is to navigate them. As the holy Baal Shem Tov, Rabbi Israel Misalant, have said some 250 years ago, that the evil will become a seat carrying the good. Meaning, if I have a terrible negative jealousy, let's transform it into a positive jealousy. How do I do that? I don't want me not to have and them not to have. I'm looking at what somebody else has and I say, I want the same. I want to be as great as him. I want to achieve the same as her, but on my own accord, with my own investment, not on account of anyone else. But what terrible lust and desire, instead of navigating it or having it to basic needs such as food and other things that people have, we can navigate it to a spiritual avenue. For example, I'd like to write more books. I'd like to elevate my spiritual essence. I'd like to influence more people in a spiritual way. I'd like to be a better person. Use that jealousy in a better way. If I need more honor, honor is not for us. Honor is for God. As it says, God has reigned, he became the king, and only for God is the kingdom. So what about personal honor? Every time you do something, try and elevate it to a different place. Say, please God, or God willing, or thank God that I've got that. Understand that what you have is just a gift. It's not your right, it's not your merit, it's given to you. Use that as a given to navigate it, to help others, to serve the society, not for your own accord. This is a good starting point, which I mentioned. The rest is up to each one of you to seek and find ways and means in which we can elevate ourselves spiritually and develop our personality.